going to university is an exciting experience and an important part in the life of any youth. But oftentimes for blind students at the university, the experience comes with more stress and challenges rather than good times. Here's a story of visually impaired musician Issa Kajiri, aka Jan Lion, also a student at Makerere University, who is living it all, the good and bad times. Issa Kajiri, thank you so much for making time to come to PM Live.
Yes, you're welcome, and thanks for giving me this opportunity of being part of you.
I'm curious, how exactly did you get here?
Well, I just had to go pick a border. You know, I have a couple of border guys that really do trust. So I called one of them and said, like, here, I have to get down to Urban TV. So could you come and give me a drive over? So he came around and then I had to pull me down here.
And what happens after this interview? Will you call the same person? How do you get back to the campus?
I will have to go with somebody out the road, then, you know, call just any border guy that can really accept work with me, then we can go with him. So I can go directing him because I know the area of head. I have this circumambulation around my brain, you know.
And how is it like inside the university, your day-to-day activities, your routine, getting to, say, your lecture hall?
Well, my lecture rooms are quite distant from where I sleep. It's a very big distance. So what happens is that I have a colleague called Robbins, and wherever is this big as yourself. So this colleague is very good, comes around every morning and picks me, say like, hey Jan, let's go right to class, and we always move with him to class. And then after the lectures, he does return me to my, you know, hostel or living hall called Livingston Hall.
And what if Robbins is not available on a given day? Maybe something has happened to him or he has some other commitments elsewhere. How do you go to the lecture hall?
Well, being a friendly person or a social person, I don't rely specifically on him in his absence. So in his absence, I have another colleague, Tito, that also is very good. And besides, I can just call anybody that is around and I can pick my call and say, hey, come push me class. And then they come around and they never refuse.
Now, do you feel Makerere University provides sufficient facilities for people like you, visually impaired, you know, systems that can help you just make your life a little easier?
And Makerere as a university does provide what it can. So I personally want to appreciate whatever the university does, because look here, we have a lot of issues put in place that really does much to support and aid our academics while in the university. For example, besides the scheme, the disability scheme that the university alongside the government put for persons with disability to go, university in as far as points are concerned, because there are a considerable number of points that you have to have that then you have to go campusing, but which you as a person without any disability, you may not really find yourself given that opportunity. So that's the first ground. Then secondly, the university also goes ahead providing us accommodation freely. And I'm thinking this is really great because most of us would not really manage to make it up if commuting. So a room is given, and you know, with two beds, so it's quite a full room that you're really given. Then besides that, the university goes ahead to provide us with guides. These guides are paid by the university.
So you mentioned earlier that you have spent 3 years at Makerere University so far. How have these 3 years been, and what course are you offering?
Mental health and community psychology. Well, it's been a very good course because it's proper, one owns whatever he or she's undertaking. So I want to say it's a very good course that I feel proud about and I feel proud of as well. So I'm thinking that, since first year, I've only been getting and gaining much more about how best I can deal with communities out there, how best I can deal with people's behaviors, people's thinking, mind, and, you know, understanding.
This other name of yours, Jan Lion, which is your stage name, you happen to also be a musician. Tell me more about this. I'm excited.
So, my name is Jan Lion, that stage name stipulated before. Yes, I'm a musician. I do specifically raga, despite the fact that I also go a little bit versatile. Well, I handle raga, reggae, you know, reggaeton, hip-hop, R&B, I can also do that part. I can also do compose music for myself, and I can also, you know, compose for anybody that really wants me to do. So, of course, well, I started this longer than one could expect, because immediately I thought that I now understand what is to be round about me. That's the childhood age. I could start singing what I could sing by that time. But developingly, as I went on academically, you know, with a lot of advancement in it, and you know, intelligence, and you know, understand what's around the camp and the environment, so I had to also advance. So it's of recent that I thought about you know, professional music to go about. That's about 2014, so it's just a couple of 2 years ago. And I've made several tracks being recorded in different studios that I've been recording all the audio so far.
Now, doing music, is this something, a career path you're growing? Is this something you want to do after graduating from Makerere University?
Oh yes, truly. Because when I started thinking about professional music, I thought nothing about my academics being a link or a relationship that even after or even any failure could lead to its failure. But this one is a talent that I have to go with, you know, alongside my academic, you know, progress and support or evidence. My talent has to be exploited and, you know, explored. So I'm thinking, yes, well, my academics has much to pertain, but you know, it doesn't have anything to go negative about it. Just as not to go positive about it, provided additional information and, you know, additional knowledge that I get about it.
And lastly, just to wrap this up, the campaigns are ongoing at Makerere University for the next Guild President. What are your expectations from this person? It's going to be a gentleman, all the candidates are men. And to just be specific, what are you going to be voting for?
This person should be greatly concerned about the students that really voted him, you know, and trusted him and trusted him. They are forward to go and, you know, present and represent them. Not a person who is yes. We want a person who can oppose where, you know, students have to feel pain about. We want that person who can oppose where necessary, you know.
Issa Kajiri, it's been nice talking to you. Thank you so much for your time. Thank you.
You're welcome. And thanks for also your husband as well.
The good and bad stories of the day. The Waki goes to all those who don't value culture. You are our Waki for today. And the dope is to Nemo Stars, who've made it to Egypt for the African Club Championships for the fourth time. You are our dope for today.
Streets is watching.
You are watching PM Live.
Let's see what's being said on our social media pages concerning the Batman versus Superman premiere. Urban TV is giving away free tickets for you to catch the movie this Thursday. If you're not hooked up yet, then keep following the Batman v Superman hashtag for a chance to win. Are you Team Batman or Team Superman? They're facing off in the movie Batman vs. Superman, and it's premiering in Kampala tomorrow. And we are giving away tickets. Check out the Urban TV social media pages for a chance to win. I'm Raziah Athman. It's always a pleasure having you on the show. From the entire team, be blessed.
PM Live was brought to you by GIIT.
For more information, visit us at Haruna Towers in Wandigea Kumbidi on Bombo Road, or contact the principal on 0702-516-354, or the director on 0776-945-602, or you can visit us on our website on www.giit.se.ug.